If you select Mars, you can zoom in a certain area, and then eventually you will find a space camp on Mars. So for me, the explanation for this is obvious that for argumental purposes, we're going to at least acknowledge that private companies do not have satellites orbiting planets. So apparently NASA and Google are collabing to present to you this fake CGI planet program to create a make-believe Mars. Some people are insisting that they did this on purpose, but apparently this Google Mars is supposed to be official NASA slash Google imagery, so why would there be a base on Mars? So if you ask me, they simply forgot to edit out this base. And the more I'm starting to think about this, I would even go as far as to say this could have been a clue left behind by a whistleblower from NASA. They possibly left this base in the Mars imagery as a clue for anyone that finds it to know that these pictures are not real and all of the imagery for Mars is fake, because Mars is really not a solid object. NASA already admits that at least four planets are actually gas giants. And this is a scientific admission that planets are actually gas giants. And to me, I would describe a star as a gas giant. So basically, science is admitting that planets are stars when they're saying Jupiter and Saturn and Uranus and a few others are actually gas giants, not actually solid objects. And like I've said before, I believe every single planet is not a solid object. I would classify planets the same as stars. The only detailed images of planets are from NASA. And as we're proving with this base on Mars, NASA is Photoshop's best friend. And so I'm wondering, how does a satellite actually orbit Mars when there's no atmosphere? So this video is proof that NASA is
going to change from the Antarctica to Mars, and they're going to tie the Antarctica to Mars, and the Martian microbes seeded the life, and that in the under the ice in Lake Vostok, and in the, if you will, the quiet, calm, tropical paradise that exists under the ice, which basically the Germans spelled out in detail, they're going to announce that the Martians created us.
Color calibration module, which has four lobes on it, and those should be blue, orange, green and brown in that image, and that's how you tell whether the image is calibrated correctly. Just tell us about that, Ali.
Yeah, so we see this on a couple of the, and we saw this with some of the Viking images as well, where you have this colour calibration chart, and you know, you can see that these panels which were blue on Earth have turned red when they're on Mars. Right. Now this is not possible by reflected light. You can't, if you have a blue piece of paper or a blue piece of paint and you shine red coloured light onto it, it's not going to show up red. It's going to become like a muddy grey or something. But in these images, it shows up red. And so what should be muddy grey shows up red. And that to me shows that there's been colour substitution of the blue colour range for a red colour range.
You know, this is fairly well accepted with a lot of researchers, that they are messing with the colours on Mars, and they're deliberately making the sky look red and the ground look more red.
Yes, I mean, we can say that it's Gil Levin, he said this with analysis he's done. He designed one of the Viking experiments. Holger Isenberg, Goro Adachi, you know, I've looked at this as well. But there's been a number of people that have pointed out these anomalies.
And of course, there's two explanations, obvious explanations. The first is that the Martian sky is blue and they're trying to hide that fact and make it look red. Or it could be that the images weren't taken on Mars, they were taken on Earth, and the reason why they made them look red is so that they don't look too much like the Earth.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of the researchers who've said, hey, look, the Martian sky is blue, I think they could be barking up the wrong tree.
It's possible.
We're placing far too much faith in JPL and NASA.
Here. So I keep digging a little bit deeper, and I finally get underneath this cloud cover here, and a few images pop up. And I say, oh, images, what are they? Well, this is what you got, which I'm sure that looks familiar to you, right? Looks just like the pictures they give us of Mars. So I'm just kind of creeping around here and definitely noticing the same kind of undulation changes and same kind of rock, same kind of dirt. Only thing that's missing is that nice little red tint that they pay somebody $150,000 a year to put on there. And then I see little things there. So, well, it's not Mars because they got some weird little tires and little ATVs over there. But I was just kind of looking around. See what we could find. There's another one of those ATVs. Some antennas set up. But those mountains, those rocks, definitely exactly like we see on Mars. So I said, I wonder what they're doing out here. What is all this equipment for? I'm sure it can't be NASA, right? Whose orange Hummer is this? Okay, that looks like a NASA symbol. Well, let's dig a little further because I can't really see anything on here other than certainly looks like a NASA symbol. And I can't read that. Tried. Cameras set up, tents, ATVs, food. They've been there a while. It's not a one-day trip. Got their antennas set up out in the middle of nowhere in Greenland. Another ATV, a leveler equipment. So, that was all that picture had. Let's see what this one's got. So this one here said, roving the Arctic. So what is that? Doesn't make any sense. Pop in here. See if we can find anything. Again, same kind of mountains. That looks like the same kind of water I've seen before that I thought was water on Mars. Who knows? Zoom in, what's that? Nothing. Just looked like it was funny. So I'll keep kind of going through here and see if it... What the... Yeah. So. I think I found out where Mars is, guys. It's just about 1,000 miles north of me. Not quite the distance that NASA says. But I can't find anybody who's in charge of this. They must be hiding behind these rocks. Oh, no, there they are out in front of everybody. Just standing there. Lovely. Clown number one, clown number two, and clown number three. These fools. All right, let's